Hi students, today we are going to see a poem. Its name is The Ant and the Cricket. So actually this is a fable. What do you mean by fable? Fable is a story often with animals as a characters that convey a moral. Actually in fable these animals, so animals are given like human characters. In this story they are able to speak anything, and with the help of this speaking quality they convey moral values to people. Okay, so here if you see, first we will know about the ant and cricket, and then we can move on to the fable. Then first cricket, then ant. Now let us go through the poem and then I will give you summary. So if you see here different stanza, okay, so stanzas are there. So you know what you mean by stanza. So stanza means, in suppose when you read in passage, paragraph, in essay we tell paragraph, in poem we tell this is stanza. Okay, this is stanza. So first let us read first stanza. A silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me. So here if you see this, actually this is a story. The story is in between and the cricket. So ant means you might have seen at home everywhere, cricket also you might have seen at home in everywhere. Okay, so here this quality, this ant, it is very active, it always does its work. At the same time if you see the cricket, so during I am explaining about the first stanza. Okay, so during the summer time this cricket, so the cricket never does any work, only singing, dancing and enjoying. So now the winter begins. Okay, so winter season begins. So for that, now at his home in cupboard there was empty. See, in cupboard there was empty means there was no food, anything. Okay, so after that when it comes out of the house and it sees everywhere, in all the places it is covered with snow, that's the reason there is no any food. Okay, on the ground also no food, and everywhere there was no flower and there is no any leaf on a tree. So now it is thinking, oh, what will happen about my life. Okay, so now next stanza. At last by starvation and famine made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with the cold, away he set off to Mysore ant, to see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful of grain. He wished only to borrow, he would repay it tomorrow, if not he must die starvation and sorrow. So now this cricket thinks that, so it is better I have to go to ant, so I have to get some shelter. So shelter means, you know, that staying place. So I have to take shelter from ants. At the same time I have to take some food, means here food means grain. So I have to take some food particles also from the ants, and I have to return that tomorrow. Okay, so I have to borrow right now and I have to return it tomorrow. If I don't get it, then definitely no doubt I will die. So now it is going to ant's house. Ant's house means the ants, ants hills. So after that, now see, now it is reaching to ant's house. Then reaching there, it is asking two ants about shelter and grains, everything. Now the ants says that, the ant to cricket, I am your servant and friend, but we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was cold and cricket not I? My heart was so light that I sang day and night, for all nature looked gay. You sang, sir, you say. Go then, says the ant, and dance the winter away. The sending he hastily lift the wicket, and out of the door tan the poor little cricket. Folks call this fable, I will warrant it true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two legs. So now this is the last stanza. See, now the cricket, it is reaching to ant's house and asking about shelter, about food, okay, and grain, everything. So the ants are saying, see, you are our servant or you are a friend, okay. So now this is the time we see, we never borrow anything, we never lend anything. So we never take any things from other people also, and we never give any things to other people also. This is means we don't like to give anything, we don't like to take anything from others. Now the answer asking to cricket, then during this summer and spring, what did you do? The answer asking to cricket. Now cricket says that during the summer and spring, actually my heart was light. So I was singing and dancing, I was enjoying, just I was time passing. Okay, now the answer telling, okay, then you are enjoying, you are dancing during summer and spring. So now also just you go and dance in during this winter also, and you chase away in the winter season. Okay, so now with the heavy heart, with heavy heart, the cricket did not get anything, and with heavy heart now it is returning to his home. Okay, so from here what we learn is, see, this is a time in this is a story, what message is conveying to us is actually during our youth time or in young time we have to work. So students, now you are studying 8th standard, so we have to work more and more. Okay, we have to do lot of hard work. Then only if you do hard work now, in future we can get good job, and in future we can enjoy. People, those who are doing hard work and doing lot of effort right now, definitely in future they will be happy. Otherwise, people, those who are not doing any work, now if they are lazy, means in definitely in future they will be unhappy.